Before we go into GD&T, let us first understand the engineering drawing, because GD&T is application on engineering drawing, and the engineering drawing is the most important document for any product development organization. So let us see what is the role of the engineering drawing in the product development. So a generic product development process will have three functions: design, manufacturing, and sales and marketing. The design team conceptualizes the product, converts it into design specifications. Those design specifications are sent over to the manufacturing team, who interpret them and then design the manufacturing process around them. And hence, they produce the parts as per the design. Finally, those parts are then marketed and then sold by the sales and marketing team. So this is how a generic process goes. In this process, the communication between the design and manufacturing team is critical to the success of the product, because whatever the designer has in mind, he has to specify it to the manufacturer, and the manufacturer has to understand what the designer has in mind. So the communication is very important, and that is where the engineering drawing comes in. So the designer communicates the design intent, that is what the designer has in mind and what the designer wants the final product to be, through an engineering drawing. So that engineering drawing contains the full information of the design specifications of that design. The engineering drawing is also the official document for the design. So it also acts like a record, and whenever there are changes in the design, the record gets revised, and hence it also helps in the change management of the design. So the engineering drawing is used primarily for communication and documentation in the product development, and it is a very, very critical document for the design and manufacturing of the product.